Today I'm going to show you how you can record videos not only on the front-facing camera of your smartphone, but also on the rear-facing camera at the same time, so you can do crazy stuff like this. What up guys, welcome back to another episode. My name is Eddie Bear, and first of all, Happy New Year to you. I know I've been absent on YouTube for the past weeks, but there's a good reason for it, cause I've been traveling New Zealand for 4 weeks straight, and let me tell you this, in my opinion, there is almost no more beautiful country in the world than New Zealand, and there was so much stuff to explore. But I know you're not here to learn about New Zealand, you're here to learn how you can record on both sides of your smartphone with one little app at the same time. Today we're going to talk about an app called Double Take from Filmic, and you have heard me talk about Filmic in the past, because when it comes to high quality video recording on your smartphone, there is pretty much no way around Filmic Pro, because they have all the bells and whistles your regular video recording app on your smartphone is normally missing. But before we continue, I know this will upset a lot of you guys out there, cause Double Take is only available for iPhone 11 and iPhone 11 Pro, cause it has the necessary processing power to display 4 streams and record 2 streams of video at the same time. So unfortunately, there will be no support for older Apple devices. And at this point in time, there is no word about an Android support whatsoever. And before I show you more cool ways to use this app, let's talk basics. So here we are in the app, and there are not many options to choose from. So here on the top left corner, you can see all your previous recordings, and they all need to be exported in order for you to be able to use them in whatever you are editing in. On the bottom left corner, you can select the different view angles, so you always have a B and an A camera. Your A camera basically will be the biggest screen you will have available, so I'm going for a selfie cam, and my ultra wide will be my B camera, so I can switch between these two cameras. Here on the bottom, you can see I have selected 24 frames. So if I want to, I can switch to 25 or 30 frames. But since we are always recording in cinematic-ish settings on our phone, I'm going for 24 frames. So once I'm happy with all my selectings, I hit confirm, and then I'm back on my main screen. So you've already seen this little bracket that was showing up for a short moment. So this is your exposure setting. So if I tap the camera here in the back, it is setting the exposure for the camera here. You can see you easily can also move this box around to adjust your exposure constantly. But if you want to lock it in, you need to tap it a second time. So this way your exposure will be locked into place and stays this way. Also, here is my picture in picture. So I have both view angles at the same time on my display. If it's in my way in whatever I'm recording, I can just swipe it away. And with this little arrow, I can bring the image back in. Also, if I want to focus on the other side of the camera, I can enlarge the view and, you know, focus on the thing that is behind my phone, or basically is my B camera. And also I can minimize it again. Hey there, it's Future Me. And while I'm editing this video right now, I started to notice that it's turning into a massive multicam project. So if you want me to teach you how you can edit multicam projects, let me know down in the comments below. And by the way, this is how this whole thing looks at the moment. So this is one of the biggest multicam projects I did so far. So let me know. Now you may be wondering, why would you even ever want to record on both cameras at the same time on your iPhone? Well, actually there are a bunch of use cases that really benefit from such a feature. So let's say I want to talk to you face to face. Therefore, I normally would use the front facing camera so I can see myself here in the corner. but also maybe I want to show you something on the other side. Normally, for this, I would need to stop the recording, switch the lens to the back, and then you always need to stitch all that stuff in post. This way, you just easily record both lenses at the same time, and as I'm talking to you on this side here, I also can show you something on the other side, so you can see here my Atomos, my EOS R, my whole recording rig, and at the same time I can switch angles and point here to the camera and show you my rig here in the back. So there's no easier way to record all the stuff you're doing at once without the need to record it in multiple camera setups. So this way you have a way easier job in post. And the cool thing is, that's not only the one feature it gives you. The recording mode I just explained to you is called discrete, which means that both camera angles are recorded into separate video files, so you will not see the one image in the other recording, so you can basically edit both video files to your liking. And there is also an option to record both cameras into one file, so you can use it, for example, on social media or any kind of other video platform. Accessing this feature is pretty easy. You just tap on the feature selector on the top right corner and you can see it already says PIP. So this means the box I'm dragging around here is recorded into my video later. So if I now hit record, this video will be burned into this main video here. I can also switch to the back to explain whatever I want to explain to you. Then if you have a talking part, you already can switch back again and forth and back. This is how easy it is to record with this app. And we're still not done, there's one more option. So back in the app, and we are selecting now split screen. The split screen option is the one where it gets really crazy. So I can see myself here on the left side and my other camera on the right side, so which is my back facing camera. But you can see in a moment I'm reaching forward, I'm already getting so close to the camera that it's, in my opinion, too close, since we are losing the space above my head and below and also on both sides. So with the back facing camera, it's a little bit better since the ultra wide camera is way wider than the selfie camera, but it's more like an interview position where you can, you know, put your camera onto a tripod or something and it's sitting between you and your interviewed person, which would make this way easier. Aside from that, I don't see too much practical use for this kind of view setup. Another option for you to record videos is that you can use your, for example, ultra wide and telephoto lens at the same time. So if you enter your lens settings, you can select the ultra wide and the tele lens, and this way you're now able to record a wide angle shot and a close-up scene at the same time. So this is a really cool thing because you don't need to zoom into whatever you're recording in post. You can record everything you need right from the start. You just need to set up your scene correctly. Okay, so what is there overall to say about Double Take? I think Double Take is a really unique tool and it gives me possibilities that I never had before to achieve something like Double Take does within one little smartphone. You had to have two cameras and tripods and stuff like that. And yet again, you now can all do that stuff just in your smartphone. So I mentioned last year that I think 2020 will be an interesting year for smartphone creators. And well, I guess this is proof that we are going to see way more cool stuff coming ahead of us. So if you haven't already checked out my previous tutorials on how to create better videos just on your smartphone, make sure to take a look at them. And if you enjoyed today's video, don't forget to like, share, subscribe. And with that said, thank you for watching and I see you in the next one. Peace.